Thank you very much. Thank you for that question. That was a very good introduction to my speech about mobile commerce. And because we are our big business is to drive digital commerce, we really enable online commerce companies to drive sales on the internet. But today I'm going to talk about mobile, because 2012 is really the year for mobile. Don't you agree? I have to admit, I'm a mobile geek. I've been saying that since the 90s. I started in mobile phones in the middle of the 90s, and this was a long time before TradeWeb even existed. I was inspired by Alec Ross, who talked about the companies that didn't exist in the 80s. TradeWeb didn't exist in 99, when it was founded by two entrepreneurs, Swedish entrepreneurs, in the kitchen, with an American idea to bring it to Europe. At that time, I was doing a mobile business in Singapore, trying to launch stock trading on mobile phones, cinema ticketing on mobile phones, and a number of things, crazy things on mobile internet before we had iPhones or iPads. We had small web screens. You couldn't do anything, but we tried really hard. But this time, now we can really do something different. And as a matter of fact, 99, when TradeWeb was founded, started by two entrepreneurs. Today we are 500 people, enabling digital commerce throughout Europe. We are present in 18 countries in Europe. We are 500 people. A good example of a successful startup that survived the dot-com boom in 2001, and throughout now in 2012, we have 75% reach in Europe. But I'm going to talk about mobile today and the importance of mobile commerce and to the Italian market. You can also wonder why we are here, a Swedish company. And but as I said, we have an American business model in as a basic business model that we started with. We have very many American important clients that want to sell something on the net, whether it's travel or fashion or consumer products or electronics. And then we have a number of local publishers here in Italy and local clients in Italy as well. So we really bring US and Italian business together and enabling that. So let me start by going to zoom in here on mobile. So it's really a big opportunity for mobile in the mobile commerce channel. Very much so, because it hasn't really happened in the Italian market yet. We think that the opportunity is huge. It's been a lot of hype around mobile. There's still quite a lot of hype around mobile, but we shouldn't be scared about that. If we look a little bit closer on how much purchase is being done on mobiles today, you can see here in the UK, it's about 226 euro per user and year. And in Germany, it's about 140 euros per user. And in Italy, it's only 27. So it's kind of 5 to 8 times bigger spend in the bigger markets. So it's a huge opportunity that the Italian market can benefit from. I also think another very important thing here is in Italy, we have very high penetration on smartphones. We have very high penetration on broadband. So I think this combination, where Italy is a very advanced mobile market, is creating quite a big opportunity for m-commerce. If we then continue and look a little bit closer here on what's happening with the consumers, I think we are in a big change right now because of kind of the recession, and consumers are changing their behavior. They're shopping in a different way. They're more concerned about cost and price. They really want to make a good deal. They really want to compare prices and really make sure that they feel that they have control of what they're buying and getting the right and the best deal every time. So I think that's really changing, and that we see that strongly in Europe, in all the different markets, that this is changing right now, and that's not going to change back. So it's very important to adapt to this change. And the way that consumers are shopping online today, much more aggressively. And if we look then specifically in Italy, why isn't the business and purchases done on mobile phones today so high? and it starts here. And if you look at the online spend in general as a percentage of the total retail spend, it's only 1.3% in Italy, while in Germany it's 9%, and in the UK it's 12%. So I think there's a phenomenal opportunity to when this online spend will increase. And why do we have this situation then in Italy? Because 60% of the Italians who don't shop online, they say they want to see the things in person before they buy. That's kind of that's one of the reasons. People want to see what they buy, and they are also very loyal to the retail stores. So I think that's one of the reasons that we see. If we then continue here, back again to the shopper, and I think this is an opportunity because now the shopper can really have the cake and eat it at the same time. It's a big opportunity, and companies have now an opportunity to actually engage with the consumer in the store, and they may come from a traditional internet site doing research, coming into the store, and if we can connect them in the store using the mobile phone, whether it's an offer or a voucher that you can bring into the mobile store and then you can cash it in and get a discount or a very good offer, then you can tie the offline back, the online back to offline and vice versa. I think that's a very important opportunity that we have right in front of our nose. If we're looking then what's happening in some statistics here we can see the m-commerce sales growth in selected countries in Europe in 2012. As you can see, the average growth is about 60% right now, and Switzerland is in the top, but you can see here that it's growing quite fast in Italy. It's a big opportunity for growth, and Italy is definitely in the top here, at least in the middle, and with huge opportunities for growth in m-commerce going forward. If we then continue then, look at the opportunity here, the Italian opportunity. It's quite big. And one other example here is when we look at our network. We have a huge network. We generate about 34 billion transactions per month in the TradeW network throughout Europe. If you look at what's going on on mobile devices in our network today, we can see that today there is about 400 million impressions per month. Ads or clicks that's been done on a mobile phone. And that's generating 1.5 million mobile sales, that people are buying something on a mobile phone. And you can see the percentage of the traffic that's mobile right now. It's highest again in the UK, it's 7.5%, but Italy is the second highest rate of mobile purchases done in the network today. So I think that's really starting to take off now. And then you have Spain, and the average we see in the network is 4% today. So that's quite good news for the Italian market. But then if you look at the growth here, you see the black curve here, the Italian growth rate is really coming up fast, and it was actually passing the UK in the month of January this year, and then sliding down slightly in February, but really in the top markets in Europe. So I think that's the difference if you compare with many other European countries with not the same advanced mobile market as Italian market. So that's a big opportunity. If we then look at how are mobile phones being used by the consumer when you're considering to buy a product, look at the product. If there are low consideration products that you don't really need to research so much, kind of consumer packaged goods, it's quite a lot of purchases, as you can see on the net, but it's coming more and more on mobile. But the important thing is medium consideration, products that you need to research a little bit more before you actually buy them. So you can see here that's the highest category where we see both mobile research done on a mobile phone, price comparisons, product information, and actually also quite a high rate of purchases bought where you buy products using the mobile phone, either in the store or somewhere else or on the go. And the high consideration products are that take more effort to really research, and it's not the same level of purchases, but that will grow also going forward. Then if you look at what are we using smartphones for, you can see that the highest usage is search still, and then the second highest is price comparison, and the fact that shoppers today, actually, you go into the retail store and you're not really so loyal to the store any longer. You can actually take up your mobile phone and you can actually scan the price tags, and you can find a better offer maybe online or somewhere else. So price comparison is quite important, and then you see the other categories as well. Then if you look at what product categories are really being looked at on a mobile phone, it's really about multimedia. Of course, multimedia is very much buying music or buying download applications that you actually do on the phone, so that's quite natural. But the second largest category is really now clothing and shoes and accessories. So fashion and products and clothes is really taking a position. Technology, you should be surprised to know how many consumer electronics products has been bought on a mobile phone today. It's quite a lot, actually. So that's more search, and then you have price comparison. So, but it's still the same categories in the top, multimedia, and then clothing and technology products. So if we then continue here and look at the role of mobile affiliate, and mobile affiliate is really using the number of internet sites. We have 140,000 sites in the network today. Affiliates driving traffic, driving sales for our merchants. And there are huge opportunities also for mobile partners and mobile affiliates and mobile merchants. Here's a very good example. How many of you are using Shazam? Quite a lot. So Shazam is an iPhone or Android application where you can tag a song that you listen somewhere on the radio, or you want to know what song it is, who's the artist, and then you get the result on the phone, and you can buy the song, you can get more information about the artist, and this is a great example, a very successful example of mobile affiliate today that's working today. We enable Shazam and driving traffic into the Apple iTunes store in this case. When you click on the iTunes link, we are enabling that traffic into the iTunes store. And there is so much music that's being tagged and downloaded today and actually driving more than $100 million of sales of music in this channel. Another example is where I talked about the opportunity to actually link back from online to offline in the store. So here's an example from the UK, which is called Voucher Cloud, which is really an opportunity to find really nice deals, package deals where you can get an offer either on the regular internet site or on your mobile phone. And then you can bring this offer with you into the store or you buy directly on the phone. And here we see quite a lot of take-up for vouchers, which is a really important opportunity to combine vouchers and voucher codes and discounts, offers that you can research online and then purchase offline using your mobile phone in the store. So the future opportunities here, and what we're working on right now is to make sure that we don't miss any of the mobile opportunities. We're helping our clients, our partners, our merchants, and affiliates to really make sure that their sites are mobile ready. Whether it's an e-commerce site, the tracking has to be there, and the same thing goes for the publishers as well, or whether it's an app network. We have to track what's going on also inside the apps. So if you go back just a few months, it was very difficult to do this, but today it's really happening, and so that's important to actually make sure that we can enable the mobile commerce in all the different channels, because there are so many different channels that we need to track to make this commerce an end-to-end proposition. And then there are a number of new cases and new opportunities also in terms of new types of business models and partners as well. So I think to end, I think that The future is really here now, and it's a really big opportunity for mobile, as I said. Look at the rate of traffic and the money spent today in the Italian market, and it's really going to increase in the coming years. So I think it's really time for us now, to all of us in the Italian market, to grab this opportunity to make sure that we can benefit on the advanced mobile market in the Italian market. Thank you very much.
Thank you.